From actor Chris O'Dowd to writer Ursula K. Le Guin to artist Van Gogh to Lithuanian strongman Žydrūnas Savickas, lots of people have a creative spark. Even me. Just listen to me sing. Doo-doo-doo, doop-da-da-doo. But some people are so very brilliant in their creative field, they leave the rest of us in their wake. These are creative people who are on another level. Number 15. Vlad Yaramenko. If you saw Vlad Yaramenko turn up to a tree-laden property with a chainsaw, you might think he's there to retrieve some firewood. Instead, this talented Ukrainian artist is there to create a work of art. Using a chainsaw as his primary tool of trade, he manages to turn a simple tree trunk into an intricate piece of art that you'd struggle to believe was handcrafted. How he does it will blow your mind. He begins by sketching his chosen artwork onto a piece of paper, then holds it up to a tree trunk while creating a similar outline, but larger, on his piece of wood. He'll then get to work with his chainsaw, carving huge chunks out of the wood with what seems like no creative process. But there is a creative process. The more Vlad chops and hacks, the more the artwork comes to life. As he gets down to the finer details, he starts using an axe and chisels until you finally see a beautifully crafted art piece that looks even better than the sketch and even more lifelike than you could ever imagine a stump of wood could be. Like this video, smash the subscribe button and click the notification bell right now, or this centipede will crawl on your face when you're sleeping. Now, it's time for the odd topic. On the left of this image, you can see a tattoo, and it's a tattoo by someone who is no creative genius. It was meant to be a tattoo of popular Pokemon Pikachu, and it's rubbish. Thankfully, the person who received the tattoo decided to get it fixed, and the tattoo artist they chose for that job was a creative genius. The photo on the right is the new tattoo. Isn't it incredible? And what an inspired way to fold the original awful tattoo into the new, better one. Truly inspired. Truly on another level. If I ever get a rubbish tattoo, I know exactly how I want it fixed. And it's like this. As always, comment down below with the hashtag OddTopic and let us know your opinion in relation to what we just showed on screen. With that said, let's keep things moving. Number 14. Hayden Peterson. Hayden Peterson has always been creative, even when he was a child. He loved making animations and editing, and later developed a love for cinematography. Now, he's a photographer and videographer for Flash Photography, while also making some time for independent filmmaking on the side. There are plenty of photographers and videographers out there, but when you see some of the video clips he's put together and the vast collection of photos he's taken, it doesn't take you long to realize Hayden is a cut above the rest. He uses innovative and out-of-the-box techniques to secure the perfect photo, such as making use of smoke bombs, flares, and even fire. Many of these techniques Hayden comes up with all on his own, and he's not above sharing them with others. On YouTube, you'll find videos with many of his new photography ideas for other people to replicate. In 2016, Hayden gained his CASA UAV license. This means that alongside his current photography projects, he can also carry out independent aerial photography and videography, which opens up entirely new worlds of creativity. Number 13. Elena Sulaymanova. If you were to just take a quick glance at some of Elena Sulaymanova's artwork, you might think she's a talented photographer. From the purple flower fields to rainforests and beaches, she certainly gets to explore some beautiful places to take photos. Except, she's not a photographer. Elena is an artist from Russia, and a very good one at that. She paints with acrylic on a canvas and uses techniques so realistic that you really do think you're looking at a photograph. Some of her best pieces include surf waves that look so real you can see the reflection of the sun on the water, and the gentle rolling and peaking of the waves. Even her shoreline pieces are realistic because you can see the froth of the water and the depth of the water's colors. Russia is known for its harsh climates, but Elena seems to find beauty in these climates no matter how she paints them. Whether it's a soul green shrub in a foggy, dark, wintry forest, or autumnal colors introduced into an otherwise ordinary looking swampland, it's hard to deny that Elena's creativity is on a whole other level. Number 12. Giant Matchbox Artist. Many people like to take large items and turn them into smaller items, like ships in a bottle, for example. But then there are people who do the opposite, take small items and turn them into something giant. The Q uploaded footage to YouTube that showed a guy making a matchbox 1,500 times larger than your average matchbox. How he did it was incredible. First, he mixed up a concoction of ingredients that would form the heads of the matchsticks. He then wrapped rope around the heads of his giant matchsticks and smeared the ingredients all over the heads until they looked like massive versions of the matchsticks you buy today. Next, he moved on to making the box for all five of his giant matchsticks to sit in. A large piece of sandpaper on the outer edges formed the striker, and he crafted the lightweight box out of balsa wood, which was easy to sand and made it light to carry. With the box complete and artwork added on the front, he took it to an open field and lit a match. It was every bit as exciting as you can imagine. Don't try this at home, kids. Number 11. Klein Netwelt. Playing with clay and Play-Doh is a common pastime for any child, but why should such fun materials only be reserved for children? As it turns out, you don't have to give them up when you become an adult. In fact, you can get even more creative. Klein Netwelt always loved plasticine or polymer clay when she was a child. She enjoyed how easy it was to mold and how many colors it was available in. So rather than let kids have all the fun, Klein carried on using clay. And you can see for yourself just how clever she is. She gains inspiration for her miniature creations from the environment around her. She said she's stimulated by people, music, pictures, and nature. Her idea for creating miniature clay artwork came from a cost perspective. She would use less clay and could bake them in the oven in her own home, rather than having to invest in a larger one. As it turns out, Klein isn't the only one who enjoys what she did. She has amassed a following on Instagram of tens of thousands for her miniature scenes, creatures, and people. Once she creates something new, she uploads pictures of it along with time-lapse videos. These can help people get creative with clay themselves. Number 10. Ivan Hu. It's not always that easy to create artwork that looks real, or at least realistic. But if there's one person who's truly mastered the art, it's Singapore artist Ivan Hu. Ever since Ivan was a child, he was interested in drawing. Back then, he just saw it as a hobby, not realizing it could be much more than that. Years passed, and he eventually turned his hobby into a profession and became a full-time artist. And what he produces is genuinely remarkable. He creates 3D anamorphic style artwork on MDF or wooden boards. If you're just taking a quick look at what he's made, it's hard to believe it's not the real thing sitting right in front of you. From a kitten staring at its reflection to a koi in a pond with ripple effects, there's almost nothing Ivan can't do. He even has a knack for drawing real-life products that look like you can almost pick them up. Ivan Hu works in a cozy spot in his home and feels fortunate that he can devote his time solely to art. He also loves the feedback and responses he gets about his artwork, which surely makes it all worthwhile. Number 9. Tuba Gekil. If you're on any social media platform, you may have seen videos of people cutting into cakes that definitely don't look like cake. In fact, when you were to put the real deal beside the cake version, it's sometimes hard to tell the difference. While many creative cake makers have been trying their hand at this type of cake creation, it's hard not to point to Tuba Gekil as one of the best. Tuba from Red Rose Cake and Tuba Gekil in Istanbul takes realistic cakes to the next level. Is it a roll of toilet paper or a cake? If it's a Tuba Gekil creation, it is definitely a cake, but it's really hard to tell the difference. Her toilet paper cake even sports the textured sheets, not to mention the fine lines on top of the roll that show multiple layers. Tuba has also been responsible for some well-known creations like a croque shoe, a grilled meal, a coconut, raw chicken drumsticks, aloe plants, and even soap. If you were just scrolling through your newsfeed, you would never know they're even edible. It's only when she slowly cuts them in half to reveal the delicious cakey interior that you learn it's not the real thing. If that's not talent, I don't know what is. Number 8. Edgar Muller. Edgar Muller from Germany is a talented street artist specializing in anamorphic paintings, also known as 3D paintings. If you ever want to liven up your city streets or a public space, Edgar is the man to call upon. He doesn't just paint pretty pictures on a sidewalk, his art immerses you in a new environment, one that looks so real you would swear you really are seeing a broken-up road oozing with lava. According to his profile, Edgar can paint all kinds of illusions, whether they're on the ground or using a combination of the floor and walls. He starts his creations by creating a digital draft for his clients so they know what to expect. Then he can paint it live wherever the street, road, or building is, which takes around 5 or 6 days.
Wenn man durch die Linse guckt, die ganze Szenerie mit Bild.
Otherwise, he can paint the artwork in his studio, which can also be digitized for use as a floor sticker. His 3D street art is truly out of this world. One minute you're standing on a standard street, and the next you're falling off the edge of a waterfall or staring down into a forgotten world. Number 7. Ian Berry. Most artists use paint to create their works of art. There are also plenty of famous sketch artists out there, but Ian Berry operates a little differently. Even though it doesn't look like it, his artwork is made entirely out of denim, and it just works. His denim art was brought to life after he was cleaning out the wardrobe at his mother's house. In it, he discovered a pile of old jeans that were destined for a charity shop. But instead of taking them there, the Huddersfield local decided to create something out of them. Ian set about shaping his mother's old jeans into portraits. From a distance, they look like they've been painted, sketched, or taken as photographs. It's only when you get up close that you realize they've been cleverly put together with jeans. Ian's tools of the trade are a simple pair of scissors and glue. He then uses photographs to replicate into fabric, where he takes care to form reflections with lighter and darker jeans. He used to rely on friends and family to donate their old jeans, but he now has about 2,000 pairs at his disposal, largely donated from denim brands. Number 6. Vanessa Davis. Perhaps one of the most talented makeup artists in recent years would have to be Vanessa Davis. Vanessa studied at the London College of Fashion and has a degree in wigs, makeup, costume, and technical effects for performing arts. But she's not just good in theory, her work speaks for itself. Vanessa has produced, designed, and assisted with nearly 4 dozen operas and 5 plays and musicals. She's even collaborated with well-known names like David Bailey, Vicky Mortimer, and Zandra Rhodes. If some of her work looks familiar, then you may have also seen it in ID Magazine and Vogue. Her talent knows no bounds. She's also well known for her skeleton makeup, which is not only highly detailed, but even looks like it's computer-generated. She uses Swarovski crystals, paper, metal, sequins, and even spikes to create that winning effect. You can see her work for yourself on her social media platforms. Her Instagram page, the_wigs_and_makeup_manager, features many of her best pieces, including her famed skeleton makeup. Some of her best work would have taken hours to complete, but when you see the final result, you'll see it was all worth it. Number 5. Steve Cassino. Out of all things you could possibly paint, like canvas, houses, and even fences, Steve Cassino had something else in mind. He decided to paint nuts.
make one of these?
It's like 5 to 10 hours each.
Really? Mm-hmm.
And is this pan?
But he doesn't just paint a smile on them and call it art. He transforms them into miniature versions of characters and famous people. The transformation is so incredible, you would hardly notice it's a nut at all. Steve Cassino is a toy inventor at Bang Zoom Design. He's well known for this role, but he's definitely made a name for himself for his peanuts in recent years. It all began when he was eating peanuts one day and noticed that the shells looked like people. He used a marker to draw himself onto one, and everyone at Bang Zoom found it hilarious. A year later, while seeking out a new hobby, he decided to revisit his peanut creations. Since then, he's been featured in Ripley's Believe It or Not for his nut creations, not to mention several others. He branched out from nuts and started focusing on turning garbage into monsters. He can quickly turn a discarded tin of anchovies into a cute little critter, or a Bic lighter into a cute vertical-eyed monster. Number 4. Michael Zurcher. Even though technology has meant that we don't need to use a pen and paper as much as we used to, it doesn't hurt to have at least one decent pen. You can whip it out at fancy business meetings and have everyone remark on how nice your pen is. And there's no denying that pens created by Michael Zurcher will get people talking. Michael is a wood turner and artist who can create all manner of beautiful items like vases and necklaces. However, it's his pens that have made him incredibly popular. He spends hours crafting these one-of-a-kind pens using wood and metal and whatever other creative decorations he can think of. If you follow his Instagram account, you'll see him showing off a stunning pen he managed to create out of a pine cone. He even shows a short video clip of how he managed to do it. He's also created 24-karat gold-plated 30-caliber bolt-action bullet pens for gun lovers, acorn pens for nature lovers, and more. If you're not one of those people who lose a pen as soon as they get one, then it might be worth checking out Michael's pieces to find the perfect pen for you. Number 3. Marissa Recker. If you're looking for a peaceful, calming piece of artwork to brighten up a room in your house, Marissa Recker is the woman to see. Marissa lives and works in Madison, Wisconsin, where she creates fluid art originals using acrylic and alcohol inks. These are then presented in hand-built float frames. All of Marissa's pieces are created around the concept of movement and fluidity. She wants to challenge viewers to feel emotions that are familiar to her while sharing our shared human experience. Marissa says that each piece is a personal exercise of letting go, and just as she moves the paint freely onto the paper, she moves her heart into it as well. She has an online store where you can pick up an original piece, and they are as beautiful as we have described. The patterns are mesmerizing, and each piece is entirely unique. When Marissa isn't busy creating beautiful acrylic artworks, she's a wife, mom, and dog agility competitor. She welcomes you to view and interact with her art, and thanks people for joining her on her artistic journey. Number 2. James Sun. Many of us have worked in jobs we've hated. Some of you, unfortunately, probably still do. But if you learn about James Sun's journey, you might see that there's light at the end of the tunnel. James, too, worked in a job he didn't like as a mechanical engineer in New York. One day, he saw a video of sand art on the internet and was intrigued. He wanted to learn how to do that, and so it was. He quit his job, flew back to Hebei, China, where he was originally from, and spent a month learning how to create colored 2D and 3D sand artwork. Once you see what he can do, you'll realize he was destined for a career in art. Because of his stunning work, he has millions of followers on TikTok and tens of thousands on Instagram. All because he's managed to produce stunning portraits, logos, and animals featuring millions of grains of colored sand. He's that good that he even managed to work for some massive clients, like the NFL, where he created art for 32 teams for the Super Bowl. Number 1. Ruben Orozco. There are many ways to portray famous figures long after they've passed. We've got photos, paintings, and even wax figures. But the way Ruben Orozco works is a little different. He uses wood, resin, silicone, marble, and even hair to create realistic depictions of famous figures. From Pope Francis to Frida Kahlo, there's almost no prominent figure he can't form using everyday materials. And how realistic they are will actually border on creeping you out. While not always life-size, they look as real as a real human can look, down to olive spots on the skin, graying hairs, and dark circles around the eyes. He's created both large and small figures and spends hours turning them into something truly spectacular. In fact, just making a small sculpture look lifelike can take Ruben as long as 45 days, and that's working at a pace of 12 hours a day. According to Ruben, the most important details are not so much the portrait, but being able to capture the essence of being. He said he wants people to reflect on the greatness of being human despite the adversities. While many of us are just mastering stick figure people, these creative geniuses are whipping up works of art that can rival the Mona Lisa. Are you quite the creator yourself? What have you put together that people loved? Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time!